Maybe interesting story why the Dutch are really very active in this area. I was asked this question over lunch also, and I think one of the real reasons is that a large part of Holland is below sea level, and to really survive in a country like that, the Dutch have to be very innovative. And we have been like that for centuries, and I think that's also one of the reasons that we are still very innovative in also the area of 3D printing. So that might be one of the reasons. I would like to talk about digital construction today, and of course I will spend a lot of time during my presentation on 3D printing, but I would like to set the scene a little bit, talk a little bit about Royal BAM Group, also talk about why we are going into these digital transformation topics, and then actually show you what we are doing in this area. First of all, a little introduction on Royal BAM Group. BAM is one of these traditional construction companies. We have a lot of projects all over Western Europe, in our home markets in the Netherlands, in the UK, in Ireland, in Germany, Belgium, and also here in Denmark. And we have an international business where we do projects all over the world. We have a revenue of almost 7 billion, a terrific profit of 1.5%, which is not really terrific, of course. So that's one of the reasons we really are going into this digital transformation, to really improve this, this very low profit number. We have an order book of 10 billion and about 20,000 employees. So we have enough people, enough projects to really practice on. If you look at a number of our projects, and I just are showing a number of examples of projects we are doing. This is a very beautiful building we are currently doing in the Netherlands. It's an art depot museum, art depot collection for a museum in Rotterdam. Closer to here, the link between Germany and Denmark, the Fehmarn Belt tunnel, which we are going to start construction quite soon, I hope. We are building an on-site yard where we are going to produce these elements and then float these elements to sea, sink them to the sea bottom, etc., etc. So that's what we're doing there. 3D printing is not involved here yet, but 3D printing is involved in this project. This is the Museum of the Future in Dubai, and what we are doing here is using 3D printing techniques to print the facade of this building. So 3D printing is used in this project. And you see some of our digital construction topics, our 4D planning environment, showing you the way this this building is being constructed. And I won't show you the whole movie. And the final one is also more a civil project. This is the largest sea lock in the world, in close to the city of Amsterdam, getting the tallest ships of the world access to the city of Amsterdam, to the harbor of Amsterdam. This lock is about the size of 6 soccer fields behind each other, so it's really big, it's really massive. So you can imagine that these kind of projects are very complex and very very difficult to realize. A little bit about the why. Why are we going into this digital transformation? And one of the reasons is that traditionally our industry is very low in productivity. If you look at all the industries in the world, and specifically like industries like car or airplane industries, you have seen enormous growth in productivity in these kind of industries. But if you look at the construction industry, the productivity has declined over the last 30, 40 years. So that's not a good perspective on our industry. And if you look at the right, you see the scale of digitalization in our industry, and also that is very low. We're almost always at the lowest part of these kind of research studies. I did a presentation at Royal Shell recently, and that was the first time I could tell a company I visited that they were even lower. If you combine these two numbers, you look at digitalization on the left, you look at productivity growth on the horizontal axis, and you see that we are somewhere at the bottom left corner. So we really need to do something, really need to change, something needs to happen in our industry. And 3D printing is one of the technologies that we are investing in to really change or improve the productivity in our industry. And on this slide from the World Economic Forum, you see a number of these new technologies that are implemented in the construction industry, and specifically also in Royal BAM Group at the moment, really to improve or raise the productivity in our company. And topics like integrated BIM, prefabricated building components, 3D printing, 3D scanning, all these kinds of techniques are mentioned on this graph and are being used in BAM at the moment. There we go. And we talked a lot about 3D printing today, but I really wanted to also put it into a more broad perspective, because it's really about connecting our design environment into our production environment. And in our design environment, we are fully embracing digital technologies at the moment. So trying to get rid of all the paper and create the future using digital techniques. And our CEO always says, we make it before we make it. And with that, he means digital first or physical next. And I have a short movie now showing the vision of Royal BAM Group in just a few minutes.
This is B. The B of BAM. The B of building houses, roads and infrastructures, and the B of the bricks to be building with. Today, people, companies and ideas all move from A to B. But in the future of building, new technologies create new opportunities, making B merely a starting point. The future of building and the journey of BAM exists beyond B, in a world that's vastly different, yet right around the corner. See? This is our vision. The direction we're heading in. Our journey is from B to C. To a future where builders become creators. Where we make it before we make it. Where all the bricks follow the clicks. Where we don't start a project at the beginning, but continuously learn from past projects and experiences. Where business planning becomes co-creation with our colleagues, customers, and all our stakeholders. Where we are no longer building in isolation, but where all our structures are connected through a continuous stream of data. The more we collaborate, the quicker we unlock potential. Today we are building the present, but have already started creating the future. We are moving to see for ourselves, for our customers, and for the world. Join us today, and together we will move to C. BAM moves from B to C. Let's move together.
And in our move from B to C, we are really embracing this picture. So this is what we're really doing in the company to really get this digital transformation in place. So we start with really the digital process, which you see on the top side of this picture, before we start going into the physical part of the project. So we start with scanning a current environment using the 3D scan technologies, creating these 3D point clouds, then start designing the new situation that needs to be created. Involving all our stakeholders that are of interest to the project, so talking about the supply chain, talking about our end users, about our clients, etc., etc. Then we start simulating the new situation. So still in a fully digital mode, we start simulating, looking at the geometry, looking at how the project will look like, looking at logistics, looking at sustainability. All these topics are being simulated, and in that phase, we create our what we call our digital twin. So before we start going into the physical phase, we first produce this digital twin that we are fully agree upon with all our stakeholders. Then we go into the physical phase. We start producing as much as possible in factories, and there is where 3D printing comes in place, really using 3D printing as much as possible towards the future, and to produce the largest possible elements that can be transported to site. We really believe in producing off-site, so in factories, instead of going on-site with all the complexity of that. And we believe that these logistics will not be the biggest problem. So we go to the construction site, assemble there, and finally start the use phase. So during this whole cycle, the most important thing that we create a lot of data. A lot of data is being collected in this so-called Connect platform. and using all this data, we are improving our processes all the time, getting better all the time, using artificial intelligence techniques, collaborating with companies like IBM to really improve the way we are doing, and also giving foresight to our project managers. And just some examples of what we are doing in this area. Here an example of creating a 3D point cloud of some project in the city of London. You probably all recognize this this project. And if you look at these kind of 3D point cloud scans, you can see how accurate these already are. And we can start measuring in these kind of environments. And from there, start designing the new situation. Also an example from the city of London here, King's Cross. So designing the new situation, then start simulating using a lot of techniques like virtual reality, augmented reality to really give insight to our client, to our end users, and also to the people that need to build the situation later on site. Using simulations in the area of 4D, so connecting our schedule, our planning to the 3D model, and really doing a lot of simulations, what would be the optimal way of creating our project. And also looking here in, for example, what parts of our final project can, for example, be 3D printed. Looking at things like health and safety, and all these kind of objects or aspects are being looked in during this this simulation phase. And then when we all agree on what we are going to build, then we freeze this digital twin and we go into the physical phase of our life cycle. We start producing in factories. Here an example of one of our factories where we produce these building services elements. And when these are ready, we transport them to site and assemble them into the building. So that's in general what we are doing in our process. But now about 3D printing. And I have two examples of 3D printing which we have been active on in the company during the last last period. First one is the landscape house, probably a project that all of you know. It was shown also this morning in Henrik's presentation. A project we are have been doing together with Universe Architectures, Jan-Jaap Ruysenaars in the Netherlands. And we used the D-shape technique to built a prototype of this this project. It's supposed to be a house, and we did some work on this to build a prototype of this project. So here you see some examples of the design phase of this project, and here you see that we are doing a simulation for a scaled model of this landscape house using Enrico Dini's D-shape technique. I have a short video on that showing how that worked. So this is just piloting, trying to get some more knowledge about 3D printing techniques. But the next example, or the last example I want to show you, is for real. This and I'm saying here the world's first 3D printed concrete bridge. This morning, Henrik told me it was the second actually, but I knew about the one in Spain. But we will keep to this as being it the first 3D printed concrete bridge in the world. We're doing that, of course, not on our own. We did a lot of work with the University of Eindhoven, Technical University of Eindhoven. They're all also in the room today here. So if I will get some very complex questions afterwards, I can also ask Rob Wolfs to help me on that. engineering, Witteveen and Bos, and the materials are done by a number of companies in the area of concrete, reinforcement, etc., etc. This is the end result. It's not a very big bridge. The size is 8 meters long by 3.5 meters wide, so it's not very big. It's meant for cycles and pedestrians. But the real good thing is that we really actually showed that it's possible also to adapt to the laws and regulations in the Netherlands and really get this in place and really do this in real life and not as a pilot. So we did a lot of work in the design phase, looking at how it was would be the best way to produce this bridge. Then, of course, we did a lot of simulation. We built first a bridge on a scale 1 to 2. So an example, we built and really did a lot of testing on that bridge. If it's strong enough, if it will hold the loads that were going to be on top of this bridge. Here you see some of the execution of these load-bearing tests. And the people that were really working on this told me that it was not possible to break the bridge using the equipment at the University of Eindhoven. That there was not enough force in this testing facilities to break this bridge. So it was strong enough to hold at least our cyclists and pedestrians. And we can also guarantee that a truck can easily go over this bridge in real life. And then we started going into production at the University of Eindhoven, and you saw the picture of this facility before in other presentations. And this is where we actually built this bridge in a number of elements, and we then transported these elements to the construction site and assembled it there into the bridge that has been installed afterwards. The bridge is being pre-stressed with pre-stressing cables, and two end blocks are being produced in a traditional way, and in that way the bridge is holding up. And we are getting a lot of attention for this bridge. There's a lot of requests also for presenting about this bridge, and we are being very how do you say that? Very we don't do that a lot because it will take up a lot of time for us. Thank you. You see that all over the world this was seen as a very important step. I have a short video on the project, and then I will conclude with a slide with some of the benefits we see as a construction company. Here you see that we use a special way of reinforcing the elements, so a steel gable
is geprint
in printed during the printing process.
Moet laten uitharden en dan dat beton moet gaan neerleggen op een plek. Dat is straks verleden tijd. Straks verzin je iets achter een computerscherm. Iedere vorm die je wenst kan je maken. Op het moment je zegt dit is het, dan druk je op de knop en dan komt hij in de printer uit.
Het unieke aan deze brug is dat hij de eerste constructieve brug is waarbij alle elementen die constructief zijn geprint zijn. Ja, een van de unieke dingen van deze brug is dat er een stalen draad meegeprint is. Dus tijdens het printen wordt het draadje meegelegd en dat zorgt voor een extra constructieve stevigheid. Er zit 20 kilometer draad in en dat moet wel op de precies goede plek zitten, precies tussen de laagjes in, want anders werkt het je alleen maar tegen. En nu is het echt iets wat zorgt dat deze brug hier blijft liggen.
We zijn hier natuurlijk in het laboratorium gaan printen. Eerst de technieken onder controle en dan gaan we elementen printen van een meter hoog. En die liggen dan allemaal hier en dan loopt er iemand van BAM hier rond. En die kijkt dan in het lab en die ziet die elementen liggen, niet wetende wat het is. En die denkt dan, als ik dat omdraai en aan elkaar plak en het voorspan, dan is het een brug. En die komt dan naar boven gelopen, zit op de hoogste vloer en die zegt, kunnen wij geen brug gaan maken? Ja, en dan is er maar één moment dat je denkt van, ja dat gaan we doen. En voor je het weet, ja dan zit je er gewoon vast. En nu staan we hier.
De samenwerking met de TU is een heel bijzondere. Wat je zag is dat er heel veel passie is om te zorgen dat dit lukt. Dus mensen hebben echt dagen gemaakt die je normaal niet zou maken. Met heel veel jonge studenten die echt op drive hebben gewerkt om te zorgen dat het voor elkaar kwam.
Je hebt altijd nog die overheid nodig. De overheid doet een aanbesteding met een oproep aan de industrie om innovatief te zijn. Maar dan ben je innovatief en dan heb je heel veel baat bij een opdrachtgever die je steunt en die dat in dat proces ook meegaat en dat ook mee durft te gaan. Wat een hele belangrijke partner in dat proces is. En dat is hier in Gemert volgens mij gebeurd.
De provincie is hier heel erg belangrijk geweest. Ze hebben echt de ruimte gegeven om deze innovatie mogelijk te maken. Door mee te kijken, door op een nieuwe manier te kijken naar iets wat er nog nooit gedaan was. Dus er zijn geen regels voor. Ja, als we die ruimte niet hadden gekregen, dan was het ook niet gelukt. Het is een heel groot compliment voor de provincie en voor de gemeente die uiteindelijk zorgen dat deze innovaties tot stand kunnen komen.
We zijn een grote provincie en de wereld is enorm in verandering. Dus we zijn voortdurend aan het kijken welke innovaties moeten we toepassen om alle stekenen nog scherper op prijs in beheer te kunnen hebben of te kunnen gaan aanleggen. Maar ook op een dusdanige manier dat we tegelijkertijd aan duurzaamheid werken. Ja, en ik vind het heel mooi om te zien dat BAM samen met de Technische Universiteit en met anderen met dit mooie product is gekomen. En, ja, het is spannend, want het is een eerste stap in een grotere beweging. We kunnen lang praten over duurzaamheid en innovatie. Maar uiteindelijk moet je het gewoon kunnen laten zien. En dat doen we voor het eerst in de wereld, dus daar ben ik trots op.
Ja, wat we vandaag gezien hebben is dat we de brug hebben opgetild en op zijn juiste plek hebben gelegd. En dat is een heel spannend moment geweest en we wisten niet hoe het in de werkelijkheid zou gebeuren. Uiteindelijk is het gelukt, dus dat is een heel mooi moment voor ons allemaal.
Ja, we zijn er zeker trots op, ja. We hebben uiteindelijk de opdracht gegund aan BAM. En dat had ook mee te maken dat wij onder de indruk waren van hun aanbieding. Ik ben maar een klein radertje in het grote geheel. Maar in ieder geval toch een klein aandeel gehad. Ja, dat geeft me dan wel een goed gevoel.
Ja, dit project, als dat af is en ik zal met mijn mountainbike hier nog regelmatig komen, dan ga ik met een dik smaal over de Nieuwbrug.
We zijn ontzettend trots. We hebben met heel veel mensen hier 9 maanden heel hard gewerkt. En als het dan uiteindelijk dan leidt tot iets wat je echt kan zien en waar je op kan staan, dan is dat wel een heel mooi moment.
All right, so my final slide, if it's okay.
1 minute.
1 minute. On the benefits we see as a company. So really about reducing environmental impact and with that improving the sustainability goals of our company. And we see, for example, about half of the use of concrete material for a bridge that is as strong as we built traditionally. With that, a lot of lower CO2 emissions and a lower carbon footprint, of course. We see that doing this off-site 3D concrete printing, we see a lot of reduction in logistics because we only have to produce, transport the elements only one time, and we are not having all these suppliers of all the materials going to the construction site. So reduce logistics. We don't need any formwork. We have this additive manufacturing process where we have no more waste, so almost zero waste. We produce in a controlled environment. So using this gantry system, as was shown already before, reducing labor, improving safety conditions, which is very important for us, and are able to go into a 24/7 operation mode, and with that reusing schedule time. And we see some other benefits. I talked about that already. We are absolutely free in our geometrical freedom. We can produce anything we would like to produce, and we are using these advanced computational optimization techniques in our designs. So we see a lot of benefits, a lot of possibilities, and you can find more on our website. Follow us on our corporate website, where we have a section on digital construction, and we tell a lot about what we're doing over there. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Menno. Thank you very much.
A little bit over time, sorry about that.
Or get off my stage. No, I'm kidding. Are you also going to be in the panel, right? Do you have time for that? Okay, so we're also going to do it, but let me just do a few just questions for you.
Yeah.
So the landscape house, I noticed that it was still a rendering, you had. It was not the final house. When will that be done?
It was a 1-to-5 scale prototype.
Yeah. Okay,
and we used it as a bench in the city park.
Okay. When will the final house be done, do you think?
We are not actually working on this project at the moment.
Okay. So that's put on the shelf for now.
It's put on hold at the moment.
Maybe a little more technical question, because I think that's would be nice also in this area. Do you believe most in the robot printers or the gantry style printers in terms of 3D construction?
Personally, I think, and I'm not an expert, but personally, I think I really believe more in the gantry gantry system instead of the robot system, because of the more exact placing of the concrete.
And now you are experienced with off-site production. Have you explored any of the on-site?
I really believe that off-site production will be the way to go.
Okay.
Instead of going on-site, and I know a lot of people have different opinions.
Yeah,
on that,
this is really
for me. It's really going on-site. Especially in the type of work that we're doing at the moment. Our cities are becoming more crowded. We have short possibilities to really work in the cities because people want to sleep in the night, etc., etc. So we want to transport that to a factory.
And the areas where the money is to actually implement this style of architecture would probably be in the cities.
Yeah, in cities most of all. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we have much more freedom in factories to make noise and do whatever what we want, and instead of building in city centers or nature environments where we also don't want to disturb
true flora and fauna. Any questions from the audience? Is also possible to ask a question for the panel, which we will open up for in a second. You have one question here, sir. You can speak loud and clear. Yes. You get the microphone right there. You get the microphone. I changed my mind. Sorry.
Thank you. You speak about your project in Dubai and say that the walls are going to be 3D printed. Can you say a little bit more, who is going to 3D print it? What kind of wall going to do?
It's steel facade elements, and I don't exactly. I'm not aware of how it exactly is going to be done. But the promise to the client is that the elements are going to being produced in 3D printed technique using 3D printed techniques. But I'm not aware of the exact techniques that are going to be used. So sorry about that.
Mm-hmm. And you don't know with who you're going to do it.
I can get back to you on that.
Okay.
I'll give you my card afterwards, and let's talk about that because I don't have the details at the moment.
Okay.
Any other questions from the audience, or can we move on to the panel debate? Yes. Thank you. Give him a big round of applause. Please stay on stage. Thank you. Thank you, Menno.